Good morning, my crafty family. Welcome back to another review. I have this week pretty much busy, and last week many days I have record video twice, two video per day. And don't miss out my sparkle video that I created for two companies finished projects. It is gorgeous, lots of sparkles. It was really hot. I was melting together with my canvases outside in the sun. But today we have a new review from Ecobuy. I do have few videos unboxing from Ecobuy, not too many, but I have some videos up there. And we were working on some diamond paintings as well with you. So today I received a few days ago I received a few more things in here for you to show you, and I'm really, really excited about something that is in this bag yet. But let's start with these two cute little diamond paintings. Very tiny, but very satisfying. And why? Because they are sparkle. I love sparkles. I love gems. And this should be very cute unboxing. Very, very tiny, but very pretty canvas. Oh my goodness, it's even smaller than I thought would be. I guess, I don't know if I even pay attention to the size or not. I saw image, I liked it, and I thought, well, I need it. You know what this would be awesome for? Let me just make this a little bit more straight. Okay. All right. So what this would be wonderful for, if you have some like DIY wooden box, maybe any box, you can create this diamond paint and put diamonds on it, and then you cut it out the edges, glue this to the box. Preferable, of course, something like, maybe, you know, like some boxes the open and lid this way, or even if it's pull out, doesn't matter. But I mean, you can decorate top of the box that you keep in some of your tools, maybe some scissors, maybe some cross stitching items or diamond painting tools. This would be wonderful to have decoration like this, because for the picture on the wall, it's very tiny. I would recommend to create something like 3D project from it. So that was my attention when I ordered this one. Printers here are wonderful, very, very clear, very colorful. And we have a tool in here, regular set of tool that we all know already. And some gorgeous diamonds that we definitely need to look more close to it, because we do love gems. I see already some gems in here that I already have in my leftover collection. I might even will go through my box and see if I have a similarity, not similarity, but exactly same gems that's already open. Maybe use them first, or this diamond's actually maybe even smaller that I have. Oh, that is cute. Just give me a second. I check for the quality first. Looks to me like very, very sparkle gems. Oh, you will love this one. Yes, yes. Diamonds are very, like, the clarity of them, very nice. Some could be, oh, I don't see. No, looks good to me, you know. It looks good to me. Let me show you as close as possible. This one, look how glowing. Looks kind of like dark, but when it's like a see-through, gorgeous red colors, how much close we can get. I almost touched the lens of my camera just to show you the beauty. Look, they look nice and juicy, kind of. Yeah, they are sparkle. And not sparkle because they are gems. I'm talking about clarity of the gems. Oh, this one is pretty green. You see how it's almost like look frosty. That's how gorgeous these diamonds. And have a little bit darker color in here. Oh my goodness. Rain started again. We have more rain every day. It's pouring outside. Hopefully we can get video without thunder. See how beautiful? And then we start having all in here the special. So we have two in here of the same shape as a teardrop. They are super, super tiny. The best thing to place them is to have the, if you have the pen like for the nail design to put gems on it, this very, very thin tip work better than a regular diamond painting pen. This one is three of them shape of the, like a leaf, I would call it. And see how beautiful those gems. And then I always love this one. It's like one of the favorites. I wish we can see them like a two sides, but obviously gold side, that's what you will see on the top of the canvas. And then same shape in green colors. And then we have two reds. It's the same color, I believe. Just that this one a little bit smaller than this one. You can see the diamonds a little tiny bigger in here. And of course, we do have a B color in here in white. So very often questions about what is a B, especially for new people who don't do diamond paintings yet and just starting this awesome craft. A B diamond stands for a B, Aurora Borealis. Because it's a shift in colors, and that's how Aurora Borealis, the light go in the sky, change and shift in colors. So that's why they named these diamonds after that. Okay, so now, like, this is so cute. I think it's like probably 25 by 25, even smaller. There is a no size on the canvas itself, but in a very, very soon future, we are going to work on this canvas for sure. If Catherine didn't steal it from me, she's in a mood to do, and she's actually working on one of the Sparkles diamonds project. Now, canvas number two for the diamond painting lovers, for those who love diamond paintings. Maybe you will like this one. Let's see, I forgot what they have here. Okay, so this tree are so popular now. I see many of ladies doing them on the internet right now because they are so, like, that just the colors, the way they print it on a canvas. Even before diamonds, it already looks beautiful because of the coloring in here. Isn't that amazing? Let me fix a little bit on this side as well. Oh, pull my photo drop. Yes, by the way, this is not a tablecloth. This is photography backdrop, and I have five now different kind. There's some links under my video if you're interested, because I have very often asking questions about my backdrop. Now look at that. It's almost like peacock tail in here. Looks so beautiful. I was like, family tree. No, what this would be, tree, how you call this tree when all the branches, it's all twisted. I can't remember. Some kind of like a mystery tree. And obviously it's a more partial this one because we do have a background that you don't have to place diamonds. But that's what, thank goodness they have a very vibrant color. So even if it's not all the way with diamond paintings, you will have beautiful, beautiful look of the kind of like a sunset seeping through the branches. And it's beautiful. So let's see, because there's some fantastic diamonds in here. We have a kit in here. I like this one better than this one, and you know why? Because this one in a very good Ziploc bags. And when Catherine and I was reorganizing our trays to put them all separately on a box, you saw it in my video already. This Ziploc bags you can use to store your leftovers, and I'm really thinking to redo all my collection of leftovers diamonds and put them into this big Ziploc bags, because some of them doesn't fit in my book as I have the flip pages. So I like when they put in a Ziploc bags like this. So let's see now our diamonds, or maybe I can put this one in here and so you still can see the picture. In first one, I kind of never told you, just a minute. Sorry about that. I got too excited about diamonds. It's 16 colors in here, so that's a lot of colors. And the interesting thing is they put, let me put this away. They state DMC code for the sparkles too. They definitely different DMC code from regular diamonds that we have. But if you collect those numbers, maybe you will match your leftovers to this DMC. I don't know, they are all different or they all the same from different company gems would be numbers. So that's interesting to know that they have like a DMC code for them. Not sure how they work, but just saying. And this one have only 5 colors. Wow, that's a very little colors, but they are sure gorgeous. And the most gorgeous diamonds in here, it's this 2 metal packs in here. Oh my goodness, this one gorgeous too. Okay, it says 5 colors, but 6 bags. This two, it's the same thing. So let me start with this one. Let me check the shine from them. I would say they look a little bit dusty to me. Maybe they just need a wash and they will shine. And by the way, I would recommend all the time give them a little bit wash first and dab it off water with the paper towel, because diamonds will shine so much better. Or when you already place your diamonds on a canvas, if it's not like a partial, so the glue all cover, grab a little bit in a paper towel, spray like once your Windex cleaner and wipe your shiny diamonds. Oh, you will see how much sparkle they will be. So here it is. It looks not bad at all, but when I'm looking at through the bag, looks like bag a little bit dusty looking. So that's why I say it's good to give them a little bit of rinse under the sink in a dish. I do have even tutorial how I wash my diamonds with very little warm water with dish soap. Now this bag is packed full, and they are beautiful. They just dusty. Now this two bags, it's the same thing, but look at the chrome colors on them. Oh, how much I love this kind of gems. It is so much fun to place them on a canvas, and we have two bags of them. Then, not less beautiful, we have AB diamonds in here. Look at the shift in colors of the teardrop shape. Beautiful. And then little tiny one. This one even more sparkle. Looks like this one even more define those cuts more sparkle maybe, or maybe they just clean. Looks like bag looks very very clean, so the gems are very clean. This one looks like need maybe a little bit wash. Brains. Okay, diamonds are gorgeous, and the canvas itself are so colorful. I'm so addicted lately to this kind of this is like a brand new line of diamond paintings, and they are very popular and they are gorgeous. Okay, so now we saw with you two beautiful diamond paintings. Now you're probably wondering what's left in this bag, and in this bag, the most gorgeous cross stitch canvas. All right, I'm so super excited about this because I know that many of you will love it. And this is a 14 count Ada, so it's very easy to stitch for anybody. Let me show you the picture of it. There, look at that. And we do have similarity. I think I even have a diamond painting. It's very look like this branch, maybe even identical. I cannot recall right now. I have to go and look. But I do have a cross stitch similar to this one, but with the peacocks. If you remember, look through my cross stitch unboxing, where is a huge canvas, but this one I think even bigger, or maybe they the same size, I can't remember now. But their similarity was this kind of flowers, and it has I believe two birds of the peacock was sitting on these flowers. And these flowers to me are the most gorgeous, like a it's speak Asian. Those flowers speak Asian to me. They are absolutely stunning. And if you are a creative person who loves something different than just cross stitch, you can add to this project beads, you can add in here sequins, you can add some special gems that you can stitch on, some cute buttons, some pearls. Do you know how gorgeous and special you can make this cross stitch? Not just only with threads, but other stuff. Looks like a waterfall's behind up there. So let's see if we have to stitch this all the background will be partial. I don't know. But the size of this one, look at the size. Look at that size. 150 by 55 centimeters. So it's a meter and 50 centimeters long. It's longer than my height. Wow, isn't that amazing? So let's see this booklet first. Okay, it's in Chinese language in here. So how do I know what kind of stitches this is? Okay, so I guess this is all in full stitches because the numbers continue 16, 17, 32, 33, 46. So we have a 46 colors in here, if I'm right. And seems to me that this is all in full stitch. See, that's the way they write down up there. But I do love this Asian brand. I don't know, the classic, it says classical cross stitch, but this kind of like first of all, I love the booklets. I love that they put this sticker. This is, I believe, a sticker that you can collect in your file, just for you to remember what you have or what you're stitching. I love this one. And you can tell that colors looks a little bit different because on the print of the printer ink could be different than actual canvas colors. So we will see. Now I'm just gonna see if I didn't miss anything. If the look at that, how vibrant this, and it's actually a good size of the squares in here, so you will have a good chance to even work on it if you're working on counted cross stitch. If you wanna size like on a smaller count, maybe 11 count Ada is too big for you. You want picture a little bit more compact, smaller, with smaller stitches. So definitely you can use, like, for example, 14 count Ada or 16 or 18, and use this booklet as a guide for the counted cross stitching, because it really looks beautiful. Very vibrant colors are very sharp, so you shouldn't have any problems to work with this book. Yes, it's like a dark print in here, but depends what kind of marker you have to mark it out. Oh, so we have in here, it's break down into 16 pages. This flowers is just stunning. So should we see what we have on the inside, because it's absolutely killing me to have this package now for what, 2 days, and I did not open yet, because I want to be a wow surprise together with you. And hopefully this is like a good wow, not a bad wow, right? Are you ready? Because the magic starts now, right here. This is the magic. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, we have a tools in here. Well, that's nice. These bags are always breaking, so hopefully. Okay, now I really have to look careful, because bag is broken and my needles as well trying to escape. Let's see how many we have in here. So we have a threader. Okay, this way. So you can see threader. I need to get a Ziploc bag for this one. I might will steal one right now from Diamond Painting Tool, because obviously this one is broken. So hopefully I did not lose any. Where is my tool? Just a minute. See, that's why these Ziploc bags are so handy. So we have in here this little cute thing that they put needle through, but all in here kind of fall apart. So let me fix it. We have four good needles. Those needles that not very sharp, so you don't poke your fingers to blood, with the big eye in here. Perfect for 11 count Ada. Okay, now these tools we will put aside. Then we have our finger protector, if you know how to work with it. I try a few times. I find so not comfortable for me. I'm still fighting to find the perfect one. Someone suggested me a rubber finger for the cross stitching, and then it hit me. Yes, I do have one, but I have to now find where I put it, because I put somewhere obviously in a very, very safe spot that even I cannot find. So I have to go through my crafty containers and find a little rubber finger, so maybe that will work for me. All these pieces not work for me yet, but it's nice for them to put into the kit. So we have a four needles, And we have a threader, which I absolutely love to work with. Good, this thin piece, good even for 14 count. And both of them, of course, are perfect for 11 count, this big eye, like you go, this side doesn't go, a little bit bended, I think, I have to straighten out. But this one, a big one, you can see go nice and easy through the needle. The little one, I think the tip got a little bit bended, I cannot, I need to fix it. I have one like this too, or maybe something sticking out on the side I have to file. No, I think it's a little bit tiny crooked. I will fix that, but they are very, very good to have. Okay, now we will put this into a Ziploc bag so we don't lose our needles. And hopefully this what was just the four needles. I need to be very careful right now and check it out if I miss any other needle in here, maybe I'm not loose. So always kind of, you know, shake it out. Stuff on your table, not on your sofa. Now I'm just going to lift this and very careful make sure I don't have, wow, the rain are very, very strong. Okay, no more needles. So it was a four needles. Now we have in here two palettes, 45, 46. So yes, we have a 46 colors. Let me show you first colors. They put like one, two threads in here. The rest of you just have to do it by yourself. But this is like so satisfying. We will look through this one more close. So let's see first the shades. And one white one in here on the other side. Those pinks. This is definitely for people who love pink colors. This pen keep coming out. Because lots of pinks in here. And this cross stitching is just so dreamy. Oh, love it, love it, love it. Let me put booklet on the back. No, this booklet, I need to find a white. No, there's no white page. Okay, how about yellow? Just to kind of cover a little bit of the background. Like this. So maybe this will show you better colors in here. This one's so nice and deep. Oh, look how beautiful those shades together. There. And then on another side, or should I just use my palette? Okay, like this. Okay, maybe this way. Excellent. I think you see very well colors in here. Bright, bright yellow, not too much in here unless we have on a bag up there. Lovely. So in here we have only numbers in order. Here is 236 and the rest of on this little palette. Sometimes they have like how many threads you're supposed to stitch. This one just a simple palette. But definitely beautiful one. So let's see how much and what kind of colors we have in here in extra, because the way they packed, it's so kind of satisfying looking. And at this point, I don't know if this one canvas is full cross stitch or partial. I cannot remember at this moment. We will check it out. Oh, this is so beautiful. Look at that. Look at that. I love the way they twist. Looks beautiful together. So we have in here, where is the camera? Here it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now I mixed up. Big pack of this cream and white. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15 extras to refill. Look how beautiful. Isn't that eye candy? I call them eye candy or candy for grown-ups. Yes, stunning. So really, really happy to have all this goodness. And I like the way they cut. The length of the threads are really awesome. It could be even longer than a meter long. I love to stitch. Because this is 11 count Ada, you separate one thread on half, which you stitch in with three threads at once. So it will go fast. An 11 count Ada, you need to have a long threads because they really finish fast. So this is awesome link for this one. Are you ready to open and reveal this? I really hope this is a full stitch and not partial. I'm losing my voice. I'm too excited. I'm too excited and scared to open. I think it's a full stitch. Let me put this way. Oh my goodness, surprise! We have two more needles in here. Look at that. Wow, so all together we have six needles in here. That is wonderful because we have a four in here. Oh, that's so kind of them. Looks like the same. Yeah, it looks like the same needle that in the pack in here. Wow, that's good. That's great. And you know what? Before it came out from my canvas and I almost lost it, my needles on the sofa. So I will pull out them right now because we will toss and turn this canvas while we, you know, doing a review. So for my own safety and the safety of my kids and animals in here, I will put this all together so I don't lose it right now. Okay, will be probably not fit the whole thing in a canvas. I will show you in one long shot on the end of this video. Hopefully I remember. Now this make me happy because I was worried that all this backing will be just a printed can, like not to stitch, but it is. Oh, that's nice. Can you hear the excitement in my voice? Oh, look at that gorgeous flower right in here. And we still didn't open all the way. We are unrolling. In stitches, I didn't mention to you, it's 600 stitches horizontal. And vertical, we have 195, I believe. It says, yes, 195. Because we have marked in here 190. But obviously there's a half of the square continues, so 195. And let me unroll it. Let me unroll it more there. Oh no, this is probably the big flower that I really, really like. Wow, you definitely can creative and add some extra sparkles to this. It will be so beautiful. Look how colorful. Look how colorful. Now the symbol wise, this is what I want to see in here, because all of them in here like a big blocks, but they created in a squares, not even squares, rectangles of 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the symbols in here created block of 12 stitches. So you can recognize them easy on a canvas, which is really helpful, I have to say that. Okay, let me fold a little bit so I can show you what I mean to bring you more close. You see how symbols created, for example, arrow sideways, and they create many blocks of that. So you can go and find them somewhere in here. But the way they printed, you can see the symbols printed very nice. Also, there is a helper for you to find the color even faster that has numbers on it. So you don't even need to look on the symbols in here to find that symbol. You can literally just go into this palette, which would be on this little one, and find 45. And that beautiful green color that we just saw, 45, it's actually off-white kind of color. What's the DMC code would be for this one? 45, let's see. 45, it's a 3865 DMC code. Who do diamond painting all the time? We already know DMC colors, what they look like. So yes, lots of numbers in here I can see. See this, all those white spots? That's the numbers, and they printed nice and clear. I will have to fold it because it's so big. You see, like, I will run through those numbers. They printed very nice, visibility very good. You can recognize them very well. So basically, it's like piece of cake to stitch. You just have to find how you want to stitch this. If this is too stiff canvas for you, I already mentioned this in one of my video, you can soften up your canvas by rubbing. I'm not going to do this right now, but I did that in my other video. You can just rub it together, squish it, beaten up this canvas so it's soft. You're not gonna disturb color, don't worry. Just don't spill any liquid on it. That way you will be in trouble. But you can crunch it, squish it, mush it, and you will have a softer canvas that you can work just in your hands and stitch in two holes at once. Or you can, it will be easier for you to put later into the frame or a hoop when soft can, when canvas is softened a little bit. Otherwise, you will fight to put into the frame, will be more difficult. Gorgeous. It is so stunning. I cannot express how excited I am to show you this canvas, because so many of you love this style. And I know, and you know what, the price for this canvas, for the size of it and how much threads you will get with it, I think the price is really good as well. So please check it out, links under my video. I will link them up directly to the product that you see in today's video. Now I will spread this out, maybe even on my sofa, so you can see from far the whole picture at once, how humongous this look like. Okay, so thank you very much for the company EagleBuy for providing this product for me to review for you. Oh, I wish I can start stitch everything that I already own. It's so tempting, you have no idea. But you know, if you cannot eat, have a little bite. That's what I always say. If you're craving for something to start new diamond painting or new canvas, just start. It will get you this little satisfaction that you actually started on it. When you will finish, that's your business, you know, a little bit at a time. Don't rush, enjoy process, enjoy of the sparkles by creating, you know, those two beautiful sparkle canvases that we have with you. I'm sure you will have fun creating all this. Now, on this note, I will say, you know, thank you, goodbye, and I will see you tomorrow. But first, let's see this big canvas in one shot. All right, I definitely miscalculated something. No, this canvas not taller than I am. I'm 1.64 meters. This is 1.50 meters. I don't know what I was thinking. So anyway, this is a huge sofa, and here it is. You can see it took, it will take, if I push it over a little bit,
to the right, it will be like two cushions of the seat and a half. That's a big. There's not much we can see of right now, but yeah, looks big. So this is the full shot of it. All right, now I will say have a good day everyone, stay creative, don't forget to cross stitch and work on this gorgeous cross stitch canvases. Check it out the store, you will love it. Look at that, they have a lots of cross stitch added up there. Before it was only diamond painting, so I was surprised to see cross stitch in the store. So this is something new they have, so check it out, and I will see you tomorrow.